Many thanks for joining us on AN24 News Round. Here are the major headlines. UN lauds FG's response to ENSA's protests. Mali's former president, Souré, dies at 72. And Britain's unemployment rate eats 4.8%. The news in details after this break. The Coalition of Northeast Elders for Peace and Development has asked President Muhammadu Buhari to sack his service chiefs. The coalition, in a statement, accused the military of deploying massive strength during the ENSA's protests in parts of the country, thereby leaving the zone at the mercy of Boko Haram and the Islamic State of West African Province terrorists. The statement signed by the chairman, Engineer Zana Goni, said proactive intelligence would have revealed this lapse to the military high command had the service chiefs not been lethargic in their responsibilities. He regretted that the unbridled quest to quell the protest by all means possible and the desire to prove that they were indeed on the ground left the security in the Northeast worse than it was. He expressed disappointment that the gaps were not covered, thereby giving the terrorists a free rein in many communities, a situation that culminated in many reported deaths and destruction of properties. The United Nations has lauded Nigeria's response to the demands of ENSA's protesters. Deputy Secretary General of the UN, Amina Mohammed, gave the commendation on Monday while responding to a question on the global body's stand on the ENSA's protest in Nigeria, after a separate meeting with President Muhammadu Buhari and Vice President Yemi Osinbajo at the Presidential Villa, Abuja. Mohammed said the lessons learned from Nigeria's response to the protests are part of what will be taken into the future on how to manage conflict situations. She noted that the demands of the protesters and the steps now being taken by the Nigerian government are the building blocks to the process of needed reforms for security, as well as rebuilding trust between the government and the people. She blamed recent widespread public protests in various countries, including Nigeria, on the harsh socio-economic effects of the novel coronavirus pandemic. Proceedings on the floor of the Nigerian Stock Exchange kicked off the new trading week on a high note as several high-capitalized stocks recorded massive gains. At the close of business on Monday, the all-share index rose by 3.96% to settle at 32,243.05 points, with aggregate market value of quoted equities at a high of 16.847 trillion naira from an opening value of 16.027 trillion naira. This meant that investors gained about 82 billion naira while year-to-date return improved to 20.1%. Analysis of the market's performance showed that activity level surged impressively as the volume of stocks traded advanced by 27.7% and 60.2% to 636.01 million units and 8.24 billion units, respectively. Commenting on the performance of the market, analysts noted that Nigeria stocks are trading at their highest prices in a year as steady to impressive results by quoted companies continue to tickle the balls at the stock markets. They, however, stated that they anticipate profits taking in next subsequent trading sessions. And now away from Nigeria, Mali's former president, Amadou Toumani Touré, who led the Sahel nation for 10 years before being ousted in a coup, has died in Turkey, aged 72. His death was confirmed by a family member on Tuesday, and it was gathered that Touré died in the early hours of Tuesday in Turkey, where he had been taken for health reasons. And finally, on the news, Britain's unemployment rate has jumped to 4.8% as the coronavirus pandemic destroys a record number of UK jobs, official data showed Tuesday. The reading for the third quarter compared with an unemployment rate of 4.5% for June to August, the Office for National Statistics said in a statement. The latest figures come with most of the UK in a second lockdown. Since the start of the pandemic in March, the number of payroll employees has dived by 782,000, according to the data. In the third quarter or July to September period, UK redundancies reached a record high 314,000. This surpassed the quarterly record in the wake of the global financial crisis in 2009. The government of Prime Minister Boris Johnson has extended its scheme to pay the bulk of wages for millions of workers until the end of March next year. And with that, we've come to the end of the news on AN24 TV. Thank you for watching.